I now want to shift focus to, at this point of time, to Manohar Parrikar, former Chief Minister of Goa, former Defence Minister of India. Now, Manohar Parrikar was one man who changed a lot of things in the Ministry of Defence. He changed a lot of things in Goa, and look how difficult it is for the BJP. They are unable to find a replacement for him. At the Ministry of Defence, the way India tackles China, Pakistan, terror, the Ministry of Defence itself, the problems within, he brought about major changes in that. And when he became Defence Minister of India, I interviewed him and I began by asking him, how will India deal with Pakistan state-sponsored terror with the BJP in power? Listen in.
जब चाहे पाकिस्तान हम पर हमला कर दे, जब चाहे हमारे सिपाहियों को मार दे, जहां चाहे हमला कर दे, क्या करेंगे आप इस समस्या से निपटने के लिए?
इतना ही कहना चाहता हूं कि इसके बारे में पूरी तैयारी, अलग-अलग काउंटर मेजर्स, केवल आई टू आई और ईट का जवाब पत्थर से इज एन वेरी ब्रेव और इट अपीयर्स टू बी वेरी ऑफेंसिव स्टेटमेंट बट यू हैव टू अल्टीमेटली रिजॉर्ट टू टीच दोज हु आर रोग अ प्रॉपर लेसन हाउ डू इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजी एंड आई वॉन्ट रिवील इट हियर बट आई एम डेफिनेटली नॉट क्लोजिंग एनी ऑप्शंस ऑफ हार्ड मेजर्स
अरुण शौरी साहब ने अपनी किताब में लिखा है कि आई फॉर एन आई टूथ फॉर अ टूथ नहीं बोथ हिज आईज फॉर एन आई उसकी दोनों आंखें निकाल लो और एक दांत के बदले उसका जबड़ा तोड़ दो क्या ये रणनीति होनी चाहिए
अल्टीमेटली रणनीति में ये कॉन्सेप्ट तो रहेगा कहा ना कहा तो लेकिन केवल यही उसका सोल्यूशन नहीं है थोड़े दूसरे सोल्यूशंस भी हो सकते हैं पॉलिटिकल प्रेशर्स यूके इंटरनेशनल प्रेशर्स आई नो मेनी ऑफ देम समवन विल से दैट दे हैव फेल्ड दे हैव नॉट यील्डेड रिजल्ट पर्टिकुलरली विथ state like Pakistan where there is hardly any command and control of the situation by political leadership. These issues might have some meaning, but I feel that there are some effective measures on that count. And there are measures which can be preventive. There need not be always defensive measures. We can have definitely preventive measures. Preventive measures also can be of a different kind. We need not wait for someone to attack. One thing you must have seen this year, and particularly in last 2 months, we have responded in a manner where, in a very nice way, they call it neutralizing the enemy.
And joining me now on the broadcast is Lieutenant General Atta Hasnain, former Chinar Corps commander. General Hasnain, you'd interacted extensively with Manohar Parrikar. Let's take this step by step. This was his first interview after he became Defence Minister of India, and he spoke of a new strategy to deal with Pakistan's state-sponsored terror. Has that strategy worked, General, in your appreciation?
Thank you, Gaurav. Firstly, let me start by expressing my very deep regret and conveying my condolences to the people of Goa and the people of the entire country for this terrible loss that we have had, a loss of a great personality, someone who was very close to the armed forces. He is no doubt being missed hugely in his own state, but I think he's going to be missed very largely at the center by the armed forces of India, who were very regretful of seeing him go away after a very, very short tenure as the Raksha Mantri. Having said that, let me say, yes, I just heard your interview, and you spoke, well, you spoke about innovations, you spoke about a stronger policy on the line of control, you spoke about dealing with Pakistan more boldly. There is no doubt about it that from 2015 onwards, I wouldn't say from 14 straight away, from 2015 onwards in particular, Manohar Parrikar's, the late Manohar Parrikar's presence in the Ministry of Defense was definitely making a huge difference. His footprint there, and I met him many times when I questioned him myself on various issues, he was very proactive. He made it known that his directions were very clear to the commanders, and I think he gave a full leeway to the to the three chiefs, to the three service chiefs. One of the most important things for a Raksha Mantri, Gaurav,
yes,
is to establish a one-on-one relationship with the service chiefs.
Yes.
And I think this is one thing which Mr. Manohar Parrikar managed to establish very, very early. It's not a very easy thing to get into the Ministry of Defense, coming from a state outside Delhi, coming and getting established there. It's a maze of complexities there, different kinds of tasks, and finding your way through and having only bureaucratic advice to you is not something which is very advisable. Getting one-on-one with the chiefs,
we see a lot more
he did.
A lot more action at the line of control.
And I think with that, he could bring about a greater level of proactivity.
Sure. And we see a lot more action at the line of control. In fact, even today,
there's no doubt about it. There was a tremendous more action at the armed robbery.
Right. And there were also not two, but three surgical strikes. In
yes,
fact, now
no
we
doubt,
learn
even today,
there have been
this morning
four,
we've had in Sundarbani.
Yes. Four surgical strikes. Two in the east, two in the west. One, of course, was an airstrike. So a more proactive approach. Now, one thing which was very interesting, General Hasnain, women empowerment. Now, a lot has talked about women empowerment. There was a lot of resistance, but I interviewed Manohar Parrikar at a different occasion. This was, of course, in Goa. This was about 10 to 11 months after he'd become the defense minister. And he talked about how he was very clear. Women need to play a bigger role in the armed forces, and not just in services, but also in combat arms. So fighter pilots and in the core of military police, he said they can do a great job in defending our bases, in flying combat air patrols. Let's listen in.
Our Prime Minister has been stressing on women power. So we decided that we go ahead with it.
Was this your decision or the Prime Minister's decision, or was this your combined decision?
Prime Minister's direction is to empower women, to see that they become focal point in all sectors, including defense. This is the outfall of that direction in general. And after discussing I told Air Force to go ahead with it. Of course, the official approval might take few more time, because we want it in a framework guidelines. We want to give it to the Supreme Court also, whether it is Air Force, whether it is Army or Navy. We will like to treat women equally, subject to condition of number one, training availability and infrastructure. There are areas where these are not available, so this may take some longer time.
But that's a very big point you're making, not just as combat fighter pilots, but you're also talking about women in combat in the army.
Why not? Not immediately, of course. Why not is the question I'm asking. I can use them in same way, like as I told you, for defense position in the Air Force. I can use them for counter-terrorism network, or to fight the enemies or terrorists within the country. Mind you, the rebels and the Naxalites, they have women among their fighters.
Absolutely. Yes.
So I don't see why the national force should not have it. Of course, it can be in a phased manner, in a specified manner and specific use.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.